Hello scholars, welcome back. Today we are going to do chapter 35 from our grammar textbook. The name of the chapter is Commonly Confused Words, means the words, different words which we are using but we don't know exact meaning and exact spellings, and that's why we are getting confused that where to use these words. Okay, so let's start. The English language has a lot of commonly confused words. Okay, there is not any number, particular number is not there. There are lot of words which can confuse us. They either look alike or sound alike. Means either they will look same by spelling, or they look same, or they will sound same. Okay, they look alike means by spelling they will nearly same. They sound alike means while pronunciation they will give same sound. Okay, they sometimes are both, and they can both look and sound alike, but they have completely different meanings. Okay, whether they are looking same means spelling wise nearly they are same, or while pronunciation they are giving same sound, but that words are having different meanings. They are totally different from each other. So such words which are totally different from each other, but they are sounding like same, while pronunciation they are giving same sound nearly, and while writing if they are giving nearly same spelling, then that such words can be called as commonly confused words. Okay, so in English we have lot of words which can confuse us, and sometimes we are making such mistakes, means we will see through examples. Okay, like here you can see one word, accept. Okay, accept, accept. Okay, so how to pronounce it? Accept. We are saying accept. Like, do you accept credit cards? Okay, so what is the meaning of this accept? Meaning is to receive. Do you receive credit cards? Okay, like that. The same word in pronunciation means sound wise alike, and in spelling little bit different, but meaning wise totally different. Another word is there, accept. Okay, here spelling is different, you can see accept, and here it was accept, but it both words give nearly same sounds, accept and accept. Okay, and no one came except Mary. Here this accept, it stands for giving us meaning no other, except Mary, no other one came. Here this except means excluding Mary, no one came. Okay, so these both words, accept and accept, spelling wise they are different, but they give same sound. Sound wise they are alike. Okay, it means these words are creating confusion while using, while speaking or while writing. We can get confused by these words, but if we know, we can use it correctly. If we know meaning, if we know spelling, we can use it correctly. Okay, then next word is I'm just giving examples. Okay, next word is desert. Okay, you can see here one picture is also there, and here in this sentence, desert, they visited the Thar desert during their vacation. They visited the Thar desert during their vacation. So desert means what? A land which is totally covered by sand. Okay, that place can be called as desert. Okay, another word is there, desert. Okay, and this means any sweet dish which we are trying, which we are having after our lunch or dinner, any sweet dish. So they had mause for their dessert. Okay, they had mause for their dessert. So here you can see that these two words, this dessert and this dessert, these two words are sounds alike, right? And in spelling also they are nearly looking like same. There is a difference, very small difference, but they are looking nearly same. Okay, what is the difference here? In a sweet dish we are using two we are using double S, and here in the land which is covered by sand, here we are using only one S, single S. Okay, so these words can make us confuse, and we can make mistake by if we don't know correctly the difference between such words. That's why these words can be called as commonly confused words. Let's see one more example. Here you can see BERTH, birth. Okay, Sheena and Meena had to manage their journey in a single berth. The meaning of this berth is seat, the seat which we are getting in train or in bus, that seat. Okay, BERTH, berth. Sheena and Meena had to manage their journey in a single berth, in a single seat. Okay, like that. And one more berth word is there which you all know, that BIRTH, birth. What is your date of birth, right? So this BIRTH, birth, we all know, but there is one more birth, and the spell, the minor difference in spelling is instead of I we are using E. Okay, that is only the difference. While writing, while pronunciation, it gives same sound, but meaning wise these both words are totally different from each other. They are not linked with each other, they are totally different from each other. So scholars, in this chapter you will get so many words, so many commonly confused words which make us confuse while using that words. So what you have to do, you have to you have to see that words. If you know meaning, exact meaning, it's okay. If you don't know, try to search meaning of that words so that you can use these words very easily, and this exercises of this lesson will be very easy for you if you know exact meaning of the given words. Okay, so what is your task? You have to find out same sound words and same looking words, means the words which are nearly same spelling wise, the words which are nearly same sound wise, such words you have to search, and such meaning of such words you have to find out. Okay, and after that you have to try to solve the exercise of this chapter. In next video we will start something new. We have one more chapter to finish. In next video we will start that. Till that time, take care. Bye-bye.